We chapter 2 class 5. Today we are going to do now the transaction. We will find the twofold of it. We decide that which particular account it belongs to. A rule, we have already learned the rules of accounts, application of the rule, and we decide which account we debit or credit along with the amount. If you see on the page number 15, you have the question number 4. Let us do that example. To which account the following transaction will be debited and credited in the books of Nilima? Describe with reason. So, to decide which is debited or credited, you have to undergo with the process. The few steps are hidden in your mind so that you can decide whether the account is going to be debited or credited. So, step by step, we will proceed and we clear our logic so that debit or credit decision can be proper. Let us begin with, we are not in hurry. This is for the first time you are doing. So try to understand fundamentally with what logic, which particular account is debited and why that is debited. Number one, rupees 15,000 brought in cash and started business. So underline, two words are there. One, that cash, and second, started business. Who start the business? Owner. When owner start the business, which word we have to use in account? Capital. So the two words are one cash account, another capital account. So two words are clear. Now we know the types of account. So cash account belongs to real and the capital account belongs to personal. So the first decision to hold, second decision type of account. Now, we also know the rules of account. Real account, what is the rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here, he is starting a business. So what he will do? He brings the cash or not? So cash comes in the business or not? So that the real account, the cash is coming in. How much debited? 50,000. Second, the capital account. Capital account is a personal account. What is the rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Owner is giving money to the business or not? So that owner's account is the giver. So you have to credit rupees 50,000. So in this manner, you are going to answer few questions. You ask question to yourself, you lead to the answer. Okay? Try to do it with understanding. Here there is no mugging up. It's nothing to be a rote file. You have to understand and you have to do step by step. The second transaction, a loan of 10,000 taken from, that is Jasleen. You have taken a loan. It means Jasleen. She is the giver. And loan, how you would receive a loan? In a cash form. So the two folds are underlined. One is, that is the loan. Loan word itself indicate it's a cash that you are receiving. And the second, the Jasleen. So first, the cash account. Second, Jasleen's loan account. Cash is a real account. Cash comes in the business, so you have to get it. And Jasleen, loan. Jasleen, she is a person. In a real case, owner was the giver. Here, the third party was the giver. So, when owner gives, we write capital account. When someone else gives, we write the name of that person. So, Jasleen's loan account, person account, giver. So, our rule says, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Jasleen is the giver. So, her account will be credited 10,000 rupees. Number 3. Bank account opened by depositing 30,000. So bank is the one account, underlined word bank, and second 30,000. How you give 30,000 to bank? Obviously in cash form. So cash is to be understood. Every word is not precisely mention certain thing you have to understand. So here one account is the bank. Bank is a personal account, is the receiver. When you go to the bank and give money, you are the giver. The bank is the receiver. So bank is the receiver. Debit 30,000 rupees. Cash. Cash you have given from the business. So cash account is the real account. It goes out from the business. So goes out 20,000. So in this manner, step by step, you have to read the transaction. You have to find the two fold. Then take the decision about time. Then recollect the rule. Find out which portion of rule is concerned account, and then give prepaid or credit effect. Number next, that is a computer purchase 8,000. So underline word computer and second purchase. So the computer is an asset. When you purchase an asset, that will be recorded with the name of an asset account and not with the word purchase account. So in spite of here the word purchase is there, you ignore, because here purchase is of what? Of computer. So for you the underlying word is the computer account. It's a real, it's your asset. So real account comes in your business, that be 8,000. And cash, again a real account. Transaction to be recorded with the name of asset. Next is stationery purchase. Again, stationery is not your goods. So you cannot use the word purchase. You have to use the word stationery. So stationery account, it's a nominal, one kind of expenditure. So nominal account, expense, debit 1,000. Cash, real, goes out, credit 1,000. So when repeatedly you do so, it will be very fast come in your mind the type of account and the reason. So easily you can decide whether to be debited or credited. Now purchase made of 20,000. See, in three transactions they are using word purchase. Computer purchase, stationery purchase, and now purchase. Now in this time, we are going to write purchase account. Why? Because it is concerned to goods. Earlier purchase was your computer, second purchase was stationery. So when you deal with an asset, then you have to write the name of asset. But when you actually purchase goods, then only the account purchase will be used. So purchase account, real account comes in debit 20,000, cash again a real account, goes out credit 20,000. So in this manner, one by one, read the transaction, find the correct fold effect of the transaction, apply the type of account, debit or credit, and then the rule. Let us proceed. Next is purchase is made of 30,000 from Raman. So now you have purchased goods. Earlier purchase was of a cash. Now this purchase is of a credit. So purchase account 1, real account comes in debit 30,000. Now you have purchased it on credit. So when you purchase on credit, the name of the trader to be recorded, because the trader become your liability. So you need to remember from whom you have purchased. So you have purchased A from the Raman. Purchase a personal account is the giver, credit 20,000 rupees. So in every transaction you will find some differences there. When the name to be considered, when the name to be ignored, when the purchase to be taken, all these you have to be little careful. Next, number A, goods of 15,000 sold on cash for rupees 28,000. Two figures are given. For you, the important thing. lakh or rupees 15,000. Now here the difference is name of the party is given, so it's a credit transaction. Earlier was a cash transaction, now this is a credit transaction. So credit transaction is that the name of party will be mentioned. Leela become your debtor. So you have to remember to whom you have sold goods. So Leela now personal account, receiver, debit 15,000. Sales account, real account, goes up. The goods are going up. Credit 15,000. The next transaction is goods return to Raman rupees 2,000. So goods are returned. So when goods are purchased, we record purchase account. When the few goods from such purchase are returned, means goods are going out. So someone receives. Who is receiving? When your Raman is receiving. So Raman account, personal account, receiver, debit 2,000. And purchase return account. It's a one kind of real account because it's related to goods. So it's a real account. Goes out, debit 2,000 rupees. Next is that goods returned by Leela. Now see, the earlier transaction it was 2. 2 and by are the indicator words. When we return to someone, means goods are going out. And when the goods are returned by someone, means that person has sent back to us, so goods are coming in. So pay an attention to that word 2 and by, underline. So here, the Leela, she is the giver. So goods are coming in. You have to pay sales return account, real account comes in debit 15,000. Leela, that is a personal account, giver credit 15,000. Next, pay 500 for the carriages. Now you are paying an expense. Carriage is your expense. So your one account is carriage. And how you pay the expense? Cash. So cash is the another code. So carriage, nominal account, expense, debit, 500. Cash, real account, goes out, debit, 500. So in this manner, you have to decide which account it belongs to, the rule of that account, what is to be applied, and then decide the debit and credit. See, the another is goods of 200 destroyed by fire. When the goods are destroyed by fire, the loss will be there. So one account is going to be loss due to fire account. That is what a nominal account is, a loss. And so to be debited with rupees 200. And because the goods are destroyed, your stock is decreasing. So credit the purchase account. The second account involved here is the minus from purchase. So that purchase account, real account, goods are goes out to be credited. Next is that is the commission received. Commission received. Underline that word received. Received is an indicator word. How you have received? In the cash form, the commission is received. So the two folds are number one, commission account, that is nominal account, it's an income to be income, that what you have to credit. Second, the receive means it's a cash. So that is a cash account, real account comes in to be debit. So one account is debit, one account is credit. The last one, 2000 paid for salary. You have paid an expense. So one, underline the word salary. And second, the indicator word paid. Paid, how you pay? Obviously in the form of cash. So that one account is a salary account, nominal account, expense, debit, rupees, your 2,000. And second one, that is the cash, real account, goes out, credit, rupees 2,000. So in this manner, question number 4, on the page number 15, we have understood that how the account is debited and account is credited in the particular transaction. So that is what the question they have asked, that which account will be debited or credited in which of describe with reason. So all this what we are writing, this is the reason we are writing. And the type of account will decide the reason, personal and real. So once again recapitulate the personal account. What is the rule? Debit the receiver, credit the giver. For the real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. And for the nominal account, debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gain. See, initially you have to follow all these steps and you have to remember the rules application very well. So for the beginners, you need to write, as in the last class also I said, at least for 20-20 time, write down the rule so it will fit in your mind properly. And the identification of account, that needs a practice. So as many as more account identification practice you do. I have already assigned that the illustration exercise, illustrations as a homework, that go through those illustrations and find out the types of the account. If your type decision is wrong, your rule application will be wrong. So your debit credit going to be wrong. So most important thing is identification of type. That is required a practice. Clear? So today what we have learned, once again, we have today, find out root codes, decide the type of account, apply the rule of account, and you can create the account. This manner, keep on doing more and more transaction practice. It will help you and your concept become clear. Thank you.